video, I'm going to show you how to choose the privacy settings that are right for you on your Google account, how to review and adjust what data Google uses to personalize your experience, and how to update information you share with friends or what information you make public. To get started, go to myaccount.google.com/privacycheckup. Log in with your email address and password and click Start Now. First, let's personalize our Google experience. From here, you can turn off your web and app activity. To do so, just click on this link. Also, you can manage web and app activity directly from this link. If you want to turn off location history, click here on this link. I decided to turn on location history because I found it very handy since Google create a private map of where I go with my sign-in devices, and this map is only visible to me. Also, from here you can manage location history. What about device information? I decided to turn it on because Google is saving my contacts, calendars, apps, and other device data in my Google account. This data is used to help Google recognize things on my device, like names of my contacts and other improvements. If you want to manage device information and turn it off, you can click on this link, and also from here you can manage it directly. If you want to turn off voice and audio activity, click here and turn it off. You can also from here turn off your YouTube search history and YouTube watch history. To turn it off, simply click here. Let's go to next step. From here, we can manage what we share on YouTube. You can share your liked videos, saved playlists, and subscriptions with other YouTube users. I decided not to, so I checked all these boxes to keep my videos, playlists, and subscriptions private. If you don't want to keep it private, simply uncheck all of these boxes. Under connected accounts, you can share your YouTube activity directly on your Twitter account. I decided when I upload a video, it's automatically shared also on my Twitter account. If you want to do so, simply click this first option, which is share when I upload a video. Also, you can share on Twitter when you add a video to a public playlist, when you like a video, or save a playlist. You can choose to automatically have your public YouTube activity show up in your channel's activity feed. Don't worry, Google will never share information about activity on your private videos. What about video privacy? When you upload a video, you have the option to make it public, private, or unlisted. You can view and change the privacy settings at any time. To learn more, click here. And on this link, you can manage your videos directly. As the owner of a playlist, you have the option to make it public, private, or unlisted. You can view and change the privacy settings of your playlists at any time. To manage your playlist, click on this link. Let's go to the next step. From here, we can manage our Google Photos settings. Auto-group photos by matching faces to better search, manage, and share is automatically turned on my account. If you want to turn it off, simply click here. If you want to learn more about group similar faces, click on this link. If you want to remove geolocation in items shared by link, simply click here. I decided to not to. Let's go to next step. From here, you can help people connect with you. You can let people with your phone number find and connect with you on Google services, such as video chats. If you check this box, it will help people who have your number connect with you across Google services. To learn more, click on this link. If you check this box, that will help them find your name, photo, and other information that you made visible on Google. To learn more, click here. From here, you can edit your phone numbers directly. Let's go to next step. From here, we can choose what Google Plus profile information we share with others. When you view your profile, you will see a few tabs below your cover photo. You can choose if people visiting your profile can see these tabs by changing your settings. Directly from here, I choose that people only can see my YouTube videos, not my photos, plus ones, or my reviews. From here, you can directly edit what others see about you on Google+. If you want to show your Google+ community's post on your profile, check this box. I selected this box because I don't want Google to feature my publicly shared Google Plus photos as background images on Google products and services. If you want to learn more about this, simply click on this link. From here, you can edit your shared endorsement setting. Let's go to last step. When it comes to ads, people love to see ads and other people don't like ads at all. You can change the types of ads you see from Google when you adjust your interests, age and gender, or opt out of ads based on your interests. Please note that you will still see ads after opting out, but they'll just be less relevant. To manage your ad settings, click on this link. If you don't want to see ads at all on any sites when you are browsing on your browser, you have multiple ad blockers. Extensions you can download to your browser. My favorite one is Adblocker Plus. If you check this box, Google will send you occasional reminders about these changes. And we are done. If you found this video helpful, take a quick second to like it, share it with your friends, and don't forget to click the subscribe button to see more of my video tutorials as they released. Thanks for watching.